In the center of the Danish capital, in the heart of the city, are the four identical palaces of Amalienborg. These are the homes of Queen Margrethe II and the royal family, which has ruled Denmark for more than 1,000 years. This is the seat of power and authority in a country where more than 85% of the population is still fiercely in favour of the royal family. This particular palace is occupied by His Royal Highness, the Crown Prince Frederick. Frederick has led a life close to his public, delighting them with a modern fairy tale wedding to Australian Mary Donaldson in 2004. His Royal Highness takes an active interest to promote Denmark's effort in climate change and sustainability. It's a commitment evident in his own home. He has recently renovated the building, upgrading the standard in tune with the ethos of the country and introducing exciting new art. His Royal Highness kindly showed me round.
Your Royal Highness.
Welcome.
Many thanks. Let us move next door, and I think this shows us the size and the scale of that which you embarked upon.
Certainly.
Almost 7 years ago, with the building in disrepair, a number of rooms were chosen to become tributes to modern Danish art.
What I'm trying to say is, first of all, this is a home to me and my wife and my four kids, but it's certainly, at the same time, it's become a fantastic window opportunity for my wife and I in terms of energy saving ideas, but also the possibility to put in modern Danish art according to our taste.
But why did you want to put the modern stuff? Because there must have been people who said, with respect, sir,
certainly,
good grief.
Yes.
What is he doing? This is an 18th century building.
Indeed.
That has housed previous kings of Denmark. And this man is defacing it.
Defacing it, certainly. Of course, we had to take that into our consideration. People were amazed, so to say, that we had dared do this. We took a chance to say, but we didn't do it like a gambling, you know, on a roulette or a poker. It was calculated, but it was also calculated risk from our heart.
As we make our way through the rooms, the gambling gets greater, until we end up here.
Oh my goodness.
Where some might say he's bet the house.
What's behind me is special. To some it's controversial. To us, it's modern art, but it's also, in this particular case, a historical mark of the time. The theme is Afghanistan.
With respect, sir, this is not just a piece of modern art. This is a piece of political theatre.
Well, it's an interpretation, Richard. It's about... I don't want to put politics into it.
You knew eyebrows were going to be raised with this piece.
I certainly did, yes. But then again...
Did you want to?
Yeah, in many ways. Of course. I thought it was good to challenge people, but I think that's what I like about modern art. It makes people talk.
Modern art. It's not always obvious where the art stops and the furniture begins.
I mean, sir, with respect.
It's supposed to be to have a clock on each side.
Yes.
Obviously, it's on a long-term repair.
Oh, I see. It's not. I see. So there's meant to be a clock there.
Yeah.
Right. It's not. I thought that was the idea. Oh, right.
This bold process was about more than painting the walls and cosmetic change. Behind the striking artworks lies a building that's been renovated from top to bottom to reflect Denmark's wider goals of greater energy efficiency.
Now in the palace.
When this palace was changed into what it is now, a livable modern palace, they understood that this is a young family that has to live and spend the rest of the days in this palace, and thus it has to be updated to modern standards, also with regards to green technology. All the radiators, for example, and the whole heating system was changed. We contained the energy consumption as much as we could. There was new coating on the pipes, and thus we could take away 700 meters of piping that was put in 60 years ago.
Do you have something against furniture?
Even the artworks showcase green technology.
Oh, I see they're mirrors.
Yeah. This is a very good way to combine what it's all about, what the whole refurbishing of this palace was about, all about. At the same time, you have usable modern art, art that serves a purpose. But here we also have the fact that the source, the light source, is LED lighting, which is obviously very, very energy low.
The rest of the world is learning about sustainability. We are still experimenting. You are on to Copenhagen 3.0, aren't you?
Yeah.
It's in the DNA here.
It's in the DNA in the fact that in the 70s, when the first oil crisis kicked in, Denmark really had to think radically in those days, and we already there turned to alternative energy sources, and this is what this palace is a symbol of right now. That you can combine an old 18th century palace or house, if you wish, with a modern standards in green technology, which are not particularly visible, but they are here.
Signs of tradition, bold signs of change, and informal signs of normal family life. A great deal of care and thought went into the renovation of the Frederick VIII Palace. It says something not only about a young royal family, but also about the progressive nature of this city and country where they rule.